is Cristian and I'm a DevOps engineer at Bunnyshell. In this video, we will look at ephemeral environments in the context of Kubernetes. First off, let's try to understand why we need ephemeral environments in the first place. Now, building something new is an exciting journey, which can be made better by having the right processes in place. One of the most important processes, in my opinion, is to set up your environments. Now, you're probably familiar with the four basic environments. First of all, we have the development environment. That's where developers start. Then we have the testing environment. That's where you set up all the tests that you want to run in order to make sure that you can quickly integrate the new blocks of code. Then we have the staging environment. That is your pre-production environment. And that's where you're trying to expose certain stakeholders to your product just to make sure that it looks and feels right. And last but not least, you will have your production environment. That is the environment your users are exposed to. Now, what you will also want to make sure is that work can move through these environments in a stable and predictable fashion. For example, let's say that you've developed a new feature. You want to make sure that it goes into testing and the automated tests will run. And if everything is successful, then we can go into staging. And that's where the stakeholders can look at all these new features. And then eventually it can end up in production. If you only have one developer, this whole process is easy. Work can follow through. However, as soon as you have multiple developers and bigger projects, more features in the pipeline, actually a lot of this work can get stuck. If you only have one testing environment, basically you can test only, let's say, one new release. Of course, this doesn't scale well. So somehow you need to be able to create multiple testing environments as you see fit. I hope that it becomes clear how having multiple environments is empowering for your developers, and it facilitates the progress of work throughout the development lifecycle. This is extremely important for testing. You want to make sure that small pieces of work are quickly integrated into those branches. So what are some of the qualities that you're looking for when it comes to your environments? First of all, you want them to be production-like. Why? Well, the closer they are to production, the higher the likelihood that the changes, when they reach your users, are gonna work. It can happen that testing went fine. However, somehow in production, things are not how you want them to be. The second issue you might face is data. You need these environments to have production-like data. Now, this data needs to be anonymized. So there are certain procedures that you need to have in place. Then these environments are temporary in nature. You want to spin them off, run some tests, and tear them apart. Now, last but not least, it would be nice to have them created on demand. You don't want to wait for new virtual machines to be provided. You want it to be flexible. You want them to be available at all times, as many as you want. When we look at the qualities, it becomes obvious why the name ephemeral environments makes a lot of sense. It would be unfair, in my opinion, just to tie ephemeral environments to testing, since you can get a lot more out of them. For example, you can improve the collaboration between your developers. How? Well, you can spin up an ephemeral environment and they can start sharing the links. So then they can show certain issues or problems much faster. You have a better feedback loop. It can also help with the creation of a good development workflow, both local and remote environments. Generally, you can shorten the onboarding process when you have all these environments set up. It might also become cost efficient. Why? Because you can leverage cloud elasticity. They can scale up and they can go down as you need. All this looks great on the whiteboard. However, what kind of tools do we have, or what should we do in order to be able to create as many environments as we want? First of all, you must containerize your application. The whole point behind that, or the reason behind that, is you want to be able to create the containers or the components once and then deploy them as often as you need, wherever you need them. You need this consistency, and you want to make sure that everything, when you deploy somewhere else, works in the same fashion. Now, containers are great and they're definitely a prerequisite, but still you need to put these containers somewhere. They need to run somewhere. And this is where you need a solution to manage the environment as a whole, because you're not going to have only one component. You're going to have databases, you're going to have some caching layers, you're going to have all these various components, and all of them make an environment. As such, you have two strategies. You can either start doing it manually, you can try to deploy all these on a VM, and every time you need it again, you're gonna try to spin off maybe a new series, but obviously that's not the way forward. Luckily, these days, we have various technologies that can help us. For example, there's Docker Swarm or Kubernetes. And this is where Kubernetes comes into place. Kubernetes is a container orchestration engine. So you have all these containers that you've created, and you want to make sure that they are managed by some software solution automatically. What you can do with Kubernetes is create manifests that define your environment. So you can say that the development version uses this container and that container and use these specific branches. And then you can say, of course, for testing, use some other branches. And all these are bundled in a manifest file. Now, if you go one step further, you might have heard of Helm charts. You can have a template, and then you just parameterize it in order to create a testing environment just by mentioning what are the differences between these. Now, generally speaking, it's still a somewhat manual process if you think about it, since even if you have the templates, someone would need to run them. Now, what is great about the software solutions these days, and in my opinion about Bunnyshell, is that we can take those environments and we can create new ones from templates on demand. So whenever you need a new feature to be tested, as soon as the developers commit their code, or as soon as they make a pull request, we can spin off an environment in Kubernetes, and then you can run your tests against it. And that's the beauty of it all. You can spin off as many as you need. Well, you need, of course, a lot of, you need some nodes in Kubernetes, and they have to scale up and down in order to have the elasticity. However, that is easily achievable in today's with today's cloud native solutions. I hope that it becomes a little bit clearer why and how Kubernetes makes a lot of sense in the context of ephemeral environments. And I hope that you will check out our solution if you would like to achieve agility when it comes to your software development lifecycle. Thank you very much.